Have you heard of the simulation hypothesis? This is becoming a big deal these days in both scientific circles and also in philosophical circles. The core idea of the simulation hypothesis is that our entire reality, including our world, our bodies, and our experiences, might be an incredibly sophisticated computer simulation. The hypothetical beings running this simulation would be far more advanced than us, perhaps a post-human civilization. Here are some of the arguments for the simulation hypothesis. Our own technological progress in virtual reality and simulation is astonishing. If this trend continues, it seems plausible that eventually we could create simulations nearly indistinguishable from reality. Philosopher Nick Bostrom argues that if such technology is possible, a post-human civilization would likely run many ancestor simulations. In other words, simulations of their evolutionary history. Therefore, statistically, it's far more likely we're in one of those simulations than in the original base reality. And some people also point to potential oddities in physics or unexplained phenomena that could be hints of code or limitations in a simulated reality. This is often referred to as glitches in the matrix. So, if this simulation hypothesis is true, then, according to philosophers, the consequences are profound. This is what they say. First, that maybe there's no base reality. There might be no true reality at all, but just simulations layered upon top of simulations. This calls into question, what is doing the simulation? Alien beings, computers. And if you are in a simulation, what is our purpose? Are we being studied, entertained, or is our existence part of some longer, larger computation? Okay, so it's become quite compelling right now in philosophical circles, but it can rekindles ancient debates about the nature of reality, free will, and what it means to be real. So now I think this is going in a direction which has already been addressed by non-dualists and ancient wisdom traditions who say that reality is a superposition, superimposition, a fluctuation, a projection, a illusion, a dream, a movie, whichever word you want to use, of what these guys are calling base reality. But that base reality is not some alien. It is non-local awareness, and we are a modified fluctuation of that in time, but our source is not in time. So, scientists always think in technological terms. First, they create models, then the model becomes real somehow, and the map is confused for the territory. And then, of course, we have all these explanations, computers, aliens, this and that. In a sense, of course, we're all aliens because every human being and everything on this planet was forged in the crucible of burning stars. And if there are other habitable planets, 60 billion habitable planets in just the Milky Way galaxy, according to the Goldilocks zone, they're all stardust beings. We are stardust beings with self-awareness. And when we sacrifice that self-awareness, then we come up with these hypotheses, simulation, computers, In fact, computers were created by us in that same consciousness. So, who are we? Stardust beings with self-awareness. And that is enough. That stardust being with self-awareness is projecting the experience of the universe. You are a stardust being projecting your experience of your mind, body, and corresponding universe. And that stardust being recycles, evolves, and evolution is a never-ending horizon. So, eternally, in the eternal now, you as a stardust being are evolving in a never-ending horizon into maximum diversity of experience. And the experience is your own fluctuation. And it'll come and go, but you, as the eternal being, will continue to create maximum diversity of experiences in the direction of infinity. Well, I've been rambling a lot these days, and I'm sure that I'm going to get a lot of criticism, but so be it.